Donald Trump has officially turned the GOP into a franchise, like McDonald's.
Donald Trump's team wants Republican candidates to give them a cut of their fundraising cash. The campaign is telling candidates and committees that if they use the former president's name, image, and likeness to fundraise, they should give at least 5% of what they get to Donald Trump.
When Donald Trump's daughter-in-law took over as the number two of the RNC, they looked at the books and they realized that they really had no money in the RNC. So they fired a lot of people. But then they realized they still don't have money in the RNC. And they really need money there, not for the candidates of 2024, but to pay Trump's legal fees. So how can I get money out of the RNC and out of the candidates that are running? Because a lot of people are not giving to the RNC because a lot of people want to give to Trump. And those Republicans don't really like giving to the RNC anymore because the RNC is not trying to regulate or get rid of Trump. So what people are doing is that they're giving money directly to the candidates. What the candidates are doing is saying, hey, I support Trump. I back Trump. I'm like Trump. I'm this with Trump. And Trump is saying, if you say that, candidate, you got to kick in up to me at least 5%. And I'm going to get to that at least 5% in a minute. Here's another way with pictures to explain what Donald Trump is attempting to do.
A franchise is a way of doing business that involves a franchisor and franchisee. The franchisor is a business with an established brand, intellectual property, and business systems. The franchisee is a person or business that pays an initial fee and an ongoing share of profits to the franchisor for the right to do business under their name and using their business systems. Instead of having to build your own business from scratch, the main benefit of purchasing a franchise is that you can utilize the reputation of the franchisor along with tried and tested business processes, recognized branding, and a solid customer base.
Basically, you use the name, you pay for it.
Exactly, Sarah. There was a letter that was sent dated on April 15th from the top officials in Trump's campaign saying, look, if you're going to use Trump's name, likeness, and image, then we should get a chunk of that money that you raise using Trump's image. And
people have been saying for months, stop giving to the RNC. Hell, Donald Trump even said, don't give to the RNC. Give to his PAC, give to him. The problem is people have been doing that and not giving to his PAC or the RNC, but they've been giving it to the local candidates. And the local candidates have still been saying, I'm like Trump. I stand with Trump policies. I am like Trump, and using pictures of them with Trump to say, hey, look, I'm backed by Trump. I'm endorsed by Trump. Do you know what that's called? That's called riding the coattails of the top of the ticket. Barack Obama did it. Bill Clinton did it. George Bush did it. Joe Biden did it. They all do it. You ride the coattails of the top of the ticket, which is why the top of the ticket is very important, because most people that vote for Trump are going to also vote for Republicans under Trump. It's riding the coattails. Trump don't want you to ride unless you pay for it. Now, about that 5%.
And they suggested at least 5%. And I say at least 5% because there is this interesting line in the letter that they sent. And let me read it for you now. It says, any split that is higher than 5% will be seen favorably by the Republican National Committee and President Trump's campaign. And that information is routinely reported to the highest levels of leadership within both organizations. The implication being, if you give a little bit more than 5%, maybe the former president will even know about it, and maybe the top level of the RNC will know about it. So clearly trying to encourage people to give even more.
The minimum is 5%. So what makes you think Trump won't know if you're using his name, image, and likeness when you're doing your campaign? Well, you have to submit a Federal Election Commission statement of your finances damn near every month. And he's going to know, hey, this person in this district is using your name, image, and likeness, and his campaign or her campaign has raised $2 million. He's going to call you and say, give me my 5% or we got a problem. And Donald Trump is so famous in the Republican Party, he can shut you down. The Republican Party is now McDonald's, and Donald Trump is Ray Kroc. What do you think?